Duplicate Special and Duplicate with Transform are two really useful tools in Maya that can help us distribute models around the 3D scene in a really uniform way to create some cool radial or modular designs. Let's start with Duplicate with Transform. We should note that Control plus D duplicates any object we have selected. What we might want to do though is duplicate it and then copy the first move or transform that we do on the object. To do that, all we do is start with a Control D, duplicate the object. Then all we need to do is move the object and then Shift D, which is the shortcut for duplicate with transform. If you continue pressing D while holding down Shift, it's just going to continuously do the same thing, but on the new object. So it's going to also move it from the new position. Duplicate with transform, of course, works with any of our transforms, which includes translate, rotate, and scale. So you can use any combination of these three things, and then it's just going to copy whatever transformations you applied and duplicate it to the next object. Duplicate with transform is great for quick and easy distributions of objects, but sometimes you'll need something a little more accurate. This is where Duplicate Special comes in, where we can manually type in some values to get some really accurate distributions. With your object selected, head up to Edit and look for Duplicate Special. Hit the little option box on the right of the word, and this will open up a little box we can explore. We're only going to look at this second section here that holds our transforms. This is where we can type in some values to control how our object gets distributed, as well as choose how many copies we want to. As they are not actually labeled here, we do need to know that going from left to right, these boxes represent the X axis, the Y in the middle, and on the right we have our Z axis. Let's now have a look at some examples of what it looks like when we change some of these values and do a few duplicates. First off, just a simple translate here. We can see we've added a value of 2 to the x-axis, which means after each duplication, the cube just moves on the x-axis by 2 units. We can of course combine these translates. So in this case here, we're just adding the 2 on the x, but also a 1 value on the y, and we get the staircase kind of effect. Adding a 15 degree value to the X rotation here, you can see as the cube gets translated on the X axis, it also rotates. This time, if we have some rotation on the Y value, it actually causes the cube to rotate as it translates, as this is done on an object-based transformation mode. Combining multiple rotation values here is going to give us some interesting effects, although not too useful most of the time. Applying some scale value here now, we can see that if we only do it on one axis, we're going to get a stretching effect on the object. To achieve uniform scaling, we have to add the same value to every single axis. Be aware that scaling is of course exponential, so it can get out of control really quickly if you're not careful. Let's now look at another use case for Duplicate Special. We're going to make a modular fence here. So we have this fence post and we want to distribute evenly along this board here. This will give us a section of fence that has uniform spacing between all the fence posts, and we can use that to create a larger fence. The first thing we need to know is the length of the fence, so we can then work out the mass to distribute the fence posts evenly. If you're unsure about the size of the object you're using, you can always press Ctrl T to open up this transformation tool, and this actually shows measurements along the length of the sides of the object. Now I know the length of my object, I just have to do a bit of maths to work out how many posts I would like. In this example, I've gone with 10 posts, so I need 9 copies, and I need to put a bit of a transform of 2 on the x-axis each time. Combining all the duplicated objects, I've now created this modular piece of fence that I can move around and create longer bits of fence because I know everything has been evenly spaced according to the maths. The last thing to check out here is to see how editing the pivot point is going to affect our duplications. This is incredibly relevant on radial duplications especially. If we'd like to duplicate an object around a centered point, essentially what we need to do is move the object away and then center its pivot point to the center of where we would like the duplication to occur. Press D on your keyboard to go into pivot edit mode, and then move the pivot point to where you would like to center the rotation. I've used X here, the shortcut to snap to grid. You could of course snap this to the center of a cylinder using something like snap to point, which is hold V. Your object should now rotate around its new pivot point. In this example here, all I'm doing is using J, which is my rotate snap, and then duplicate with transform to rotate these cubes evenly around the center point. This method is of course great for just quick and easy radial duplications, But if we need to duplicate more objects than our snap scale allows us, we're definitely going to have to use our duplicate special for this. You can see here I've duplicated 20 cubes around this circle shape here by dividing 360 by 20 and giving me a value of 18 degrees. You may notice the number of copies is only 19 here, not 20. This is because we have to use the original object in the calculations. You can still combine this with other transformations to get some really cool looks. You can imagine how you could create something like a spiral staircase really, really easily. To finish off, I just wanted to have a quick word on the difference between copy and instance, which is the option right at the top of the duplicate special option box. Essentially, a copy is a completely new object. It will have its own attributes, it will have its own UVs, and it's a different object on a component level as well. An instance is an actual instance of the original object. That means if you change its components around, its UVs, they will be all shared on everything that is an instance of that object. Instances are, of course, a bit more efficient on the computer. A big thing for games is that they share UVs, which means you're only going to have to UV and texture one of them. The downside of this, of course, if you want some changes between each object in the world, you won't be able to, as it's going to be the exact same texture on each one. So the choice here essentially boils down to, if you're okay with the object being exactly the same in its shape and texture, go for an instance. If you need to make alterations between each object, just choose copy.